I will try to remember to go to Brackenbury next, though. Absolutely. Nothing much to see in here. This painting shows a row of warriors standing atop the walls of Defiance Bay while Adir's ships sail away. Sail away, sail away. Joining the Crucible Knights is a high honor. Yes, yes. Yep, I knew this would be fighting time here. We defended Defiance Bay back in Duke Hadrick's day. I hope I get promised to the Justiciar soon. Wild is pretty hard on all the novitiates. Plenty of them are telling us all this stuff while they're fighting. This is Wyla. Anything to be seen around here before we talk to Wyla? It's funny, it's like a cloud getting rid of the fog of war in this section. Struggle and strife forge our spirit into a sharp weapon. The Justiciar's gaze flicks over to you briefly before returning to the novitiates gathered in the training area. If this is about patrols, my novitiates are already stretched to their limit. Between the refugee influx and the mess at Heritage Hill, I simply don't have any units to spare. After a pause, she looks over at you again. I'm sorry, was there something else you need? Is something wrong at Heritage Hill? She lowers her voice. What isn't wrong is the real question. A whole district of walking, flesh-eating corpses. We've sealed the... Really? We sealed the area 2 months ago, just after I lost one of my finest commanders there. And yet this is the second guard rotation to disappear. There are already enough rumors about the place floating around the keep without my soldiers whispering about these disappearances. Okay, rumors floating around. I thought that she meant the place was floating around. She shakes her head. I'd just as soon abandon the district, but if those monsters should find a way out... Tell me about Heritage Hill. Used to be one of the most prestigious districts in Defiance Bay, but a few months ago the residents all went mad, started eating each other, and anything else that had the bad luck to wander into the district. I've never seen anything like it. Now, every novitiate that stands guard there, everyone that comes back anyway, talks of the stench of the grave and the groans of unspeakable horrors. She holds up one plate-clad finger. The why and the how are questions for the animancers. I've sealed the district in hopes of containing whatever happened there. It seems to be working. For now. If there's nothing else, I must attend to my duties. You said early? Oh. What do you do here? I'm in charge of the Keep's novitiates. I'm responsible for their training and patrol assignments. She nods at the group gathered in the training room. They're good soldiers, and they've been quick to adapt to new challenges. I could look into the Heritage Hill issue. She steps back and regards you. After what I've just told you, you want to go to Heritage Hill? I've lost trained soldiers there. Why should I let anyone in? Your trained knights have nothing on me. If you're so eager to rush to your death, I won't stop you. She quietly looks on at the novitiates. And if you're somehow able to put a stop to this... You've got my permission to enter Heritage Hill. I'll send word to the guards at the gate. Farewell. Okay, so we couldn't even get in there before. Can't get the map from here, but I know it's one of the districts. Alright. Out of here. Okay, I've been in there. That's dinner. I'll take a look in here and then up there. I think once we talk to these people, they stop forever. Also another way into that dining area. No, not more books.
My eyes are peeled.
Oh, we have that. We have that book. Yay! Kinda tired of reading books. I like reading them. I don't want to miss one, like even one of them, if possible. But I've been reading a lot here. This is the symbol of Abaddon, a colossal smithing hammer imposed over a circular gear. It's smooth and bright with buffing oils.
Keeping an eye out.
Oh. There's nothing here. Can we put something like as a... Hold on a sec. Just want to try something. My guess is you put something there, maybe some coins. See, I don't even know how I put coins. Take all. Huh. Well, I sacrificed that battle axe. There you go.
We just don't have the manpower.
For what?
Light, flame, and sound.
Oh, he's getting like... I like to wait till the yellow goes away. I see that, what's his name? Eder has something to say to us. Oh, we can't get in that anyway. Nope. What can I do it, Captain? Although...
Slow and silent.
Yeah, I'm just gonna keep going and make this into a two-part episode. Let's check out this Edict of Arrest. Oh, another one. Okay. Collect the whole set. Development of a Crucible Knight Part 1, Lower Ranks. It's interesting reading about these guys. In recent years, the Knights of the Crucible has evolved as a group. No longer concentrating solely on blacksmithing or combat training, they've adjusted their focus to help initiates develop their souls as well as their bodies. From initiation, there is a well-defined path to the top of the order. Squire. When a candidate shows sufficient prowess in blacksmithing, or, recently, at least a drive and potential, he is accepted into the order as a squire. Once he is part of the order, training begins immediately. Lessons are divided into two main sections: body, commanded by the Lord Marshal, and soul, overseen by the Grand Crucilar. At this point in their progression, the only uniform the squire is allowed is a simple cloth uniform displaying the knight's colors. Novitiate. After sufficient training, each squire is given a three-part test. He must repair a broken piece of armor, he must recite the Canticles of Abaddon from memory, and he must be able to land a blow on a novitiate in combat. If he succeeds at all three of these tasks, he is promoted to the position of novitiate. At this point, he is given his first official piece of crucible armor, a brigandine. His training now doubles, as only the most valiant of candidates makes it through to the next level. Justiciar in Templis. When a novitiate shows he is ready, decided by his teachers and trainers, he must make a decision. His training and advancement from this point on will focus on one of the two disciplines, body or soul. Novitiates that choose body continue military training as a justiciar under the Lord Marshal. Novitiates that choose soul are given clerical training as a Templis under the Grand Crucillar. Justiciar or Templis, the newly appointed, is taken through the ritual of the arm. He is given his plate armor and symbol of Abaddon. He is then taken to the Smith's Forge, named after Abaddon, and is tasked with forging a small nail out of iron. He affixes this nail to his armor under Abaddon's symbol and will wear it there for the rest of his life as a knight of the Crucible. At this point, the knight's training is fixed. If he chose body, that is the path he is on until the end of his days. If he chose soul, there is no deviating from the course. That is why the choice is only presented after he has been through many months of training. There's more over here. Part 2, Senior Ranks. Commander and Forge Master. Once a path is chosen... that book was just too long. We had to cut it in two, you know? Once a path is chosen, the knight's life is spent training in his preferred discipline. The pomp and formalities that surrounded his life up to this point are all but gone. The training is far more rigorous, and there is less ceremony to mark his progress. For most knights, Commander, Body, or Forge Master, Soul, are further than they will ever advance. The training of a knight at this level, while almost exclusively in the discipline he has chosen, is still rounded out with instruction from the other. A knight is not truly a knight if he does not have full breadth of knowledge. When he passes from justiciar to commander, the knight is given a blue cape to wear with his plate armor. When a Templis rises to the position of forge master, he is presented with a white cloak. Marshal and Crucillar. After time spent training, an elite knight that shows true leadership potential and promise is elevated to the next level. A knight of the body becomes a marshal, and a knight of the soul becomes a crucillar. At this point, he is in command of a small group of knights, commander, forge master, and below. He is responsible for the recruitment, initiation, and advancement of new squires. Many knights do not want to advance to this level and beyond because the role becomes less hands-on and more advisory. Marshals are known by their purple capes, while crucillars are distinguished by a gold cloak. Lord Justiciar and Grand Templis. A marshal or crucillar that shows true and effective command over the knights in his keeping may be offered the position of Lord Justiciar of the body or Grand Templis of the soul. Truly a command position, a knight that accepts one of these roles will be removed from the front lines. Because of this, it is only the most dedicated leaders to take either of these positions. Lord Marshal and Grand Crucillar. There is not a single knight that oversees the entire group. This responsibility is split between the Lord Marshal, Body, and the Lord Crucillar, Soul. Any knight that advances to this position does so only with the support of the knights as a whole. He must be nominated and selected by a majority of the knights. Once in the position, he is there for life. The Lord Marshal or Lord Crucillar may step down from his post if he so chooses, but that is only to retire from the life of a knight. The stress and responsibility of this position is such that many refuse it, even if they are capable of handling it. Lord Marshals and Crucillars are well known and generally respected throughout the land, not just within the knights. Okay. Nothing else secret to look at. This map shows the environs surrounding Defiance Bay. Flags mark strategic access points to the city. This document estimates the flow of refugees over the past 3 months. The figures grow by the week. Alright, so obviously we're talking to this guy now. Commander Clyver, finally.
Refugees from every corner of the Deerwood. The dozens getting them all riled up about animancy. At this rate, we'll need twice the soldiers to patrol Defiance Bay. Yes? Can I help you with something?
Commander Clyver stands in front of a massive table, studying a map. His expression is set in a grim frown. He opens his mouth to say something to one of the men, but he follows a soldier's gaze over his shoulder to you. Why don't you have enough soldiers?
Fleetbreaker Castle. The High Justice has summoned almost half of my novitiates, and more of my justiciars, to a keep on the other side of New Haomar. It's not for me to question the High Justice's orders, but it's left us short-handed. And mark me, we're just a couple sparks away from anarchy.
Alert number 3. Causing trouble. 3 and 4 causing trouble, wow. With so many newcomers, can't you just recruit more soldiers? More recruits means more training, which means more time from experienced soldiers that I don't have. He half turns away from you. Anyhow, I hardly see how this is any of your concern, but if you've got the time to ask me about it, then perhaps you've got time to do something constructive. Forge Master Dunstan is working with an animancy scholar to build what we're calling Forge Knights. Warriors that can patrol our streets without suffering fatigue, disobedience, or fear. Some agitator throws a rock at him, we don't have to worry about things getting out of hand. He's constructed the armor, but we need the scholar's research. Unfortunately, she hasn't been around the last few times my novitiates have checked. Vianna lives with the rest of the Scriveners out in Copper Lane, but I haven't the soldiers to spare at the moment. Go to the Scrivener's dormitory and see if you can find her. When you get the research, just bring it to Dunstan. This is his area of expertise, anyway. We'll do that. Scrivener's dormitory and then back to Dunstan. Once you've brought him the research, he can sell you any arms or armor if you have need. He forges and repairs all of our equipment. You won't find a more capable smith in Defiance Bay. Yes, that's what everyone keeps telling us. Was there something else I can do for you? You're in charge of the Crucible Knights? Here in Defiance Bay, anyhow. The High Justice is the leader of our order, but he's currently stationed at Fleetbreaker Castle. My job is to oversee our forces in Defiance Bay and to keep order for the Duke. Tell me about the Knights of the Crucible. I wish they had lines for this. He crosses his hand behind his back. We're the only professional army in Defiance Bay, or in the Deerwood for that matter. We defended the city in Hadrit's Day. We've improved our training since then, but Dunreed Row can certify that many of our officers come from good Deerwooden fighting stock. Now we're responsible for patrolling the city and keeping the peace. With so many refugees pouring in from the countryside, that's become more important than ever. Unfortunately, that's earned us enemies, particularly among the dozens and some of the more enterprising families in Defiance Bay. What do the dozens have against you? He snorts. They're demagogues and troublemakers. They forget that Defiance Bay is one of the largest cities in the world and not some frontier outpost. Most of them are mercenaries on a good day and street thugs the rest of the time. Needless to say, they have no patience for law and order. Tell me about the enterprising families. House Domino, namely. They're one of the city's oldest noble families and its largest criminal organization. Their patriarch, Gedmore, has been trying to take advantage of the turmoil to expand his operations. We've kept on top of him, and he hasn't been too happy about that. I see. Nope. Alright, we need research from Vianna. Okay, since we're done there, well, actually we're done here, we'll run right over and see if we can find her in the dormitory since we've been there. something else we can take care of and... There was something else in Copper Lane, but I think I was thinking of the catacombs. How the hell do I get out of here again? So yeah. So I guess they're making some kind of a golem, or they want to make some kind of a golem, or golem, however you pronounce it. Even the most daring of adventurers must keep up their strength. Who's this? Who is that? Crier. The hearings on an animancy proceed at the Ducal Palace. Little progress is reported. These days it's rare to find folks who'll do so much for strangers. Defiance Bay will lead the Deerwood into a new era. Smooth tongue. Are these new people? These people weren't here before. Uris Nakazul? Great, another history. Another two histories, I'm sure. You see a dwarf, matted beard, slick with rain and dirt. His teeth are gritted in the wind, cloak drawn close. He walks in formation with 21 others, all bearing the same insignia, a mercenary company. Mercenary is spelled wrong. They are all soaked with mud and filth, faces broken, shoulders fallen and soft. They do not speak as they move, gathered in an uneven circle. Their guide gestures, an officious-looking Orlin, directing them through the sodden streets towards a run-down building. The ceiling is partially caved in, and something about the too perfect door causes the party to stop. The Orlin barks at them, agitated. The mercenaries form a tight circle. Something is amiss. Then, hooves, gunfire. They've been betrayed. The fight is fast and efficient. Mercenary blood stains the cobblestone streets as the soldiers round up those remaining. A horse rears out of nowhere, kicking the dwarf in the side of the head. He falls instantly, blood seeping from his ear. The soldiers leave the mess, uncaring, their orders completed. Night falls and bodies stiffen. Rain has all but washed the street clean as the dwarf slits open an eye, groaning. He staggers to his feet, hand on his head. He leaves his cloak on the ground, insignia greeting the sky, and slowly walks away. Ruben Torres. You see a young boy sneak up the ramp of a giant black-sailed ship, smile so wide it almost cracks his wind-whipped cheeks. The ship is almost empty, crew out drinking and celebrating their latest haul. The boy easily evades the drunken guards playing cards on the upper decks, trading stories of conquests the boy doesn't yet understand, and runs down the stairs to the decks below. The ship is silent below as he explores, just a gentle lap of the ocean against the hull, and the muffled sound of excited feet running between boxes, stopping at each to peek inside. Another pair of footsteps, and the boy jumps, hiding behind a collection of sacks. The footsteps disappear, eventually, but the boy is asleep, and the ship roars into life as her drunken crew make a breakneck escape with an accidental stowaway. Interesting. Nobles. Copper Lane time.